friends, and welcome back to Water Rock Simple Science. My name is Lindsay, and today we're going to be talking about food webs. More specifically, we're going to be talking about food webs in a prairie. Prairies are an extremely biodiverse ecosystem, full of lots of different plant and animal life. And today, we're going to be exploring how all of those plants and animals are connected. So here's what you'll need. Pictures of prairie plants and animals, which are provided on the printable activity you can find in the video description below. A ball of yarn or string, scissors, and some tape. Before we get started, let's define the difference between a food web and a food chain. A food chain is the order in which living things depend on each other for food. Producers are on the bottom. Next comes herbivores, next predators, and finally decomposers. In other words, what eats what? A food web is a map of how all the food chains are connected. Let's see how this works. First, we need to cut out all the pictures of prairie plants and animals. I've already done this step for time's sake, so we can move on to the next step. Next, we'll take the picture of the sundown onto the table and make certain it's in the middle. Then let's take the different plants and animals in a circle around the sun. As you can see, we have a variety of herbivores, carnivores, and omnivores. I didn't include the decomposers because they're often too small to see. Now, tape the string to the sun and run the string to one of the plants. Then we're going to run the string from the plant to one of the animals that might eat that plant. And maybe there's an animal that eats that animal. So let's run the string there. Now we cut the yarn because guess what? We just made a food chain. You can do this over and over again with all kinds of different connections. There are so many connections within our prairie food web, and they all start with the sun.
Feel free to keep experimenting with all the different plants and animals and how they connect within the prairie. Keep making those food chains, which will make your food web even bigger. All this talk about prairies actually reminds me of our fun fact. Do you know that prairies are home to 80 different mammal species, as well as 300 different bird species, and more insect species than we can even count? That's pretty crazy, isn't it? Well, friends, that's it for Water Rock Simple Science. I hope you had fun and learned something new. If you're looking for more fun and educational content, be sure to check out our website, waterrocks.org. Until next time!